the first step is to download the Java SDK. So go to Java first. And then JavaFX, open JavaFX.io, open JFX.io, click download. And then you'll finally get where the files, the SDK files are. So we have the LTS 11.02 version of the SDK. We have the latest release, which is 15.01, and then we have early access builds, which are 16.06.16. So you choose 15.01. So you download the SDK, not the JMods. So SDK, and you download according to your operating system. If you're using Windows, you download for Windows, likewise Mac and Linux. So once you've downloaded, extracted, because it is a compressed file, so just extract it and copy it or extract it to a directory where you want it to be located. I've already done so. I've extracted mine, and it's stored in the home. I copied it to the home, and then Java leak folder. So this is the SDK. Inside it there are two folders, legal and lib. So we're interested in the lib. So go ahead and start your NetBeans. Create a new project. Just create a new project. Java it out. Yes, call it just call it FX and then create a main class called the main, then just finish, and then I want us to, what you need to do now is come here to libraries and then click and then add library. So what we'll do is add library, and then if you've not already added the library, if you're not already created, you can create, as this did, create, and you just call it JavaFX 15 Java. I'm just calling the JavaFX 15, and then I click OK, and then add a JSON folder, and then navigate now to the lib folder inside the SDK where we extracted it. So mine should be in the Java lib folder, and then JavaFX SDK, and then here is the lib. So just select all the JAR files, all the JAR files except this one. So add, and then click OK, and then so once you've selected now the JavaFX 15 that you just created, you click add library, or click add library. Good. So what we do now is write a code. Let's see, I've written my name. So we should not see any error unless there's something we've done wrong, but let's just see public request name. Let's just see, true. Yeah, we don't get any error. That means the library has been installed successfully. So the next thing that we need to do is just to configure the VM arguments. So we just right click the project, go to properties, and then from properties click run, and then from run in the VM options, I'll copy the what you need to add, the configuration. So here is the configuration. It is a module path, and then the folder, the directory to the lib folder inside the SDK, and then add modules is equal to JFX controls. So I'll just copy it to the video description so that you guys will be able to follow. So I'll just copy that and then paste it. So having pasted that, should now be okay. I just click OK and then let's try and run. We should be able to run successfully because we have done everything correctly, I suppose. Yes, so that is how you can set up JavaFX in NetBeans. JavaFX 15. Thanks guys for watching. Subscribe to my channel.